the specification, the quantities or calculate the quantity, we will come across some methods that are very simple to understand and to quantify the amount or the quantity which we will multiply with the rate available in the different CSRs for calculating the amount. Once one understands and can read drawing, they find out the dimensions and the quantities. The person who can read the elevation, the section or the plan of a building, he can easily find out the quantities which is being estimated by an estimator. If it is a beginner, he might came across first time the plan, elevation and sections of a building, so he will find it a bit difficult to understand and to just calculate the quantities. But if he practice for more times, if he practice more 3 to 4 times or like many times, then after practicing he will get to the formula and method. An internet estimator makes estimates which can be understood and checked by anybody. So an estimator can be deemed as internet if the estimate which is made by him is understood or understandable by everyone. In our quantities estimation, we deal with metric system which is very simple, and it has the quantities like tera, 10 power 12, giga, 10 to power 9, and mega, 10 to power 6. Our objective of estimation is to enable one to know beforehand the cost of the work. The basic objective of our estimation is to know the approximate quantity which we have to invest in a project to see the project in real. The estimate is the probable cost of a work and is determined theoretically. So whatever we are doing, it's a theoretical and mathematical calculation which after doing that we'll get the total estimation or total quantity, and then if it is multiplied by the rate, we'll get the total amount of the project. So the different types of estimates will come across today is preliminary or approximate estimate, split area estimate, cube estimate, approximate quantity method estimate, detailed, revised estimate, supplementary estimate, annual repair or maintenance estimate. So today we will speak about only these 8 types of basic estimates which we came across every time during construction of the project. First of all, preliminary or approximate estimate. Approximate estimates are prepared during initial stage of the project. So these projects are prepared during the initial stages or initial phase of the project. That's why they are known as preliminary estimates. The approximate estimate is prepared from the practical knowledge and cost of the similar. See, the approximate estimate is prepared from the practical knowledge or the cost of the similar element or structure which is already being prepared by that estimator or the group of estimators. In that the rate will add further 5% to 10% as a contingency margin. So for buildings like school, hostel or the hospital, per student basis for school, per hospital bed basis for patients, we will quantify the quantity taking into account per student for school and per patient for hospital. For example, approximate cost of hospital building for 100 students at the rate of 10,000 per student works out as rupees 10 lakhs. Now, second, plinth area estimate for building. This estimate is calculated by finding the plinth area of the building and multiplying it with lift area range. For example, building having lift area of 100 square meter into at the rate of the rate 900 per square meter works up to be 90,000 rupees. So this is the estimate, and this is how we calculate the estimate with the help of lift area estimate method. Next is cube rate estimation for building. This is calculated by finding the cubical content of the building. Cubical content of building is length into breadth into height, and then it will be multiplied with the cubic rate, so that we will get the quantity. So the length breadth should be taken as external dimension of the building at the floor level, and the height should be taken on the floor level to the top of the room. So we have to take account of these three things. So the example of this should be cubic content or volume of 400 cubic meter, which is multiplied by the 180 per cubic meter, comes to 72,000. So this is how the estimate comes out. Next will be approximate quantity method estimate. In this method, approximate total length of the wall is found first in running meters, and this total length multiplied by the rate per running meter. So first we have to find out the total length of the wall running meter, and then multiply with the rate per meter. This will give us the total cost to be accurate, fairly. So for that we have to divide into two parts. First, foundation including plinth, and second, superstructure. First of all running meter cost for foundation and superstructure should be calculated first, and these running meter rate should be multiplied by the two length of the wall. So this we have already explained before. To find out the running meter rate of the foundation, the approximate quantities of items such as excavation, foundation, brickwork up to plinth level, and dam proof course, which we also call DPC, are calculated per running meter and by multiplying the use of these items rate per running meter. So that will get the quantity. So for calculating all these estimates and this method, all these quantities, we have to have knowledge, or we have to have in a hand the plan or light plan or the other sections details of in our hand of that project. Next is detailed estimate or item rate estimate. It's an accurate estimate and consists of working out the quantities of each item of work and working the cost. So we have, this is a very detailed one estimate, and for this estimate we have to have the detailed drawing of that project or the building, whatever project of the building we are making. We have to have a detailed project drawings including plan, sections, cross sections, etc. So detailed estimate mainly has two stages. First is details of measurement and calculation of quantity. So first of all, we will have the details of measurement. We will take all account of all the measurements, and then calculation part will be done of all the quantities. So for that, we need to have correctly all plans, drawings, and specification under each item and computed in a tabular form. So we have made a tabular form, and we'll see all the drawings, cross sections of the building, and then we quantify the quantities, and then we will list out in a tabular form. Second will be abstract of estimated cost. The cost of each item of work is calculated in a tabular form from the quantities already computed in the prior method, and total cost is brought out in a prescribed form. So all these the total cost will be multiplied with the rate in a tabular form again, and then will be worked out in a prescribed form. Again, in this 3 to 5% is added for contingency. It means 3 to 5% of the total the cost which will be coming after calculating with the earlier later methods. Then we'll add 3 to 5% of that cost and the contingency of it for petty expenditures. And also 2% is added for the work charge establishment. For the establishment, we have to add further 2% of the money. Next is revised estimate. It is a detailed estimate which is required to be prepared under any of the following circumstances. There are mainly three circumstances which are major. First of all, original sanction estimate is accurate or likely to be accurate by more than 5%. So, first of all, which is the original sanction estimate have already administrative approval. If the estimate is likely to exceed by more than 5% or exceed more than 5%, then you have to have a revised estimate which has administrative approval. Second, when expenditure on a work exceeds or likely to exceed. So, for a particular work, if there is a expenditure, if there will be an expenditure, and if it exceeds the amount of administrative sanction for that particular work, then we have to add the revised estimate. Then, when there are material deviations from the original proposal, then we have to add a revised estimate. So, these are the three basic conditions for which we have to add a revised estimate. So, while giving the revised estimate, that should be accompanied with comparative statement showing the variations of each work, its quantity, rate, and cost under original and revised. So, we have to give a comparative statement to show that we justify our revised estimate bill, and that bill will be given for the administrative approval. And upon seeing the variations and all the calculations, the administrative approval will be given. Supplementary estimate is another form of estimate. It's a detailed estimate and is prepared when additional works are required to supplement the original work. So, if we have some point of time in the project, if we came across work which is to be carried out in addition to the prior given project element, then you should add a supplementary estimate to make that particular element. So, for that, we need to administrative approval and we have to attach a supplementary estimate. We have to produce a supplementary estimate. Next is annual repair or maintenance estimate. These types of estimates are made when we have to go for the annual maintenance of a structure for its proper and safe condition and functioning. And this includes the washing, whitewashing, then color washing, painting, minor repair, etc. Now, estimation method. The estimation of building quantities like earthwork, foundation, concrete, brickwork, in-plinth and superstructure, etc. can be worked out by any of the following two methods. We have two methods to work out these quantities. Two major methods. First of all, long wall, short wall method and center line method. The third one is partly center line and short line method. This is a combination of these other two methods for a unique case. First one is about long wall and short wall method. In this method, first step is that we have to find out the length of the length along the room as long wall and transverse to that is short wall. Then, to get the length of long wall or short wall, first we have to calculate the center line length of the long wall and short wall respectively, and then adding half of the width on either side to the long wall and subtracting the half of the width on other side into short wall. This is the reduction of half bed from its center line length. So, fourth thing, the length of long wall usually decreases from earthwork to brickwork in superstructure. So, when we go from earthwork to brickwork towards the superstructure from up down to up, the length of the long wall usually decreases and the length of short wall increases. these lengths are multiplied by the breadth and depth to get the quantities, and the quantities will further multiply to the rate, and we'll get the amount of the total estimated amount. Now, second method is center line method. This method is suitable for walls of similar cross section. First, the total center line method is multiplied by breadth and depth of the respective item to get the total quantity at the time. So, first of all, we have to just find out the center lines of that particular plan or that structure. Whatever plan will be given, for a room or full plan of that house. Then, after that, we have to multiply with the breadth and height of that particular the given plan, and we'll get the quantity. When cross walls are partitions or veranda walls joined with the main wall, the center line thus gets reduced by half of breadth for each junction. Such junctions or joints are studied with carefully with calculating total center line. Total center line length. So when the veranda cross walls or partitions are joined, or there is a junction of these by these things, we have to reduce the length of the center line by half of the breadth for each junction. So we take care of these three things. If they came across, we will subtract the value of center line. For example, if it is a plan of a room, this is a long wall and this will be a short wall. This is along the length of the room and this is along the width or transverse to the long length of the room. So this is short wall and this is long wall. Now in central method, what there is a disadvantage that when we are considering from the center of all the lengths, we will include 1, 2, 3, 4, but we will exclude 1, 2, 3, and 4. So the outer edges of the square will be forgotten and the inside will be taken into account. So to compensate this thing, we will take account of this. So at the end, the center line method will not take account of this, but instead will take account of this. So it will be, so this taking out of this thing, this is compensated by this. So if we take the quantity of this, it is exactly similar to the quantity which is here. So there will be no problem by the new center line method. Partly center lines and partly cross wall method. This method is adopted when external, that is the around the building wall, is one of the thickness and the internal wall having different thickness. So when there will be a thickness of the length of the wall around the structure and the wall depth into the structure, if they are different, then we use for this method. For that, the long walls or the outer walls will be dealt with the long wall structural method, and the inner walls width will be dealt with center to center line method. So now we will take a numerical on each of that method, long wall, short wall and center line method. So first of all, we will take one long wall and short wall method. So suppose we have a plan which is given as 5.3 centimeters center to center length of this wall and the 4.3 centimeters length of this wall. So we are taking length of long wall along the length of the room. So this is long wall. And this one will be transferred to this, so it will be treated as short. Now the question is to quantify or to take the quantities or estimate the quantity of earthwork in excavation, and second will be concreting. So we will take up the quantity of the concrete also. Then the third will be brickwork in foundation and plinth. And fourth one will be big working superstructure. Superstructure. So first of all, we have to make a tabular form to quantify all the quantities. So what we'll do now, we'll do this quantification one by one. First of all, we'll take the earthwork in excavation. So now we are going with the groundwork and shortwork method for this given numerator. So now we have a plan and a cross section along CD. So the cross section along CD is a replica of the cross section along AB. So we have the cross section of the room which has the same foundation on each edges. So first of all, earthwork will be for long wall. For long wall, the numbers will be, we have one long wall and second long wall, so will be two in numbers. The long wall for this will be, length of ground wall for this will be the center to center length plus half the width of the half the width of the foundation, the footing, and from either side, from this side and from this side. So now we are at this point. So half the means, if it is 90 centimeter width, so half will be 45 and 45. So the length of the long wall will be 5.3, which is center to center length, plus 0.45 plus 0.45, which will be 6.2. So it means meter. Then will be breadth in meter. So we found out the length in meter for the long wall. Now we'll go for the breadth of long wall. So the breadth of long wall will be, if it is the length will be this, so breadth will be this one. So breadth of this will be 0.9 meter. Now, excavation, as we all know, excavation is done below the ground level, so the depth or height will be from ground level, which is here to bottom. So it will be 0.3 plus 0.3 plus 0.3, it will be 0.9. and then we will multiply these quantities. So the quantity we need in cubic meter will be 10.04. Now, the quantity for shortfall. Shortfall also are two in numbers, so there will be two in numbers. Again, the length of shortfall would be center to center length of the shortfall, which is 4.3 minus center to center is from here to here minus this one and this one. So it will be around minus 0.45 and minus 0.45. So now we got the value 0.43 minus 0.9. It will be 3.4 meter. So the length of the short ball will be 3.4 meter, and the breadth again will be 0.9. And the height of that will be again 0.9, because for the short ball, for long ball, the height is we are taking from the ground level, which is 0.9 meter above the bottom level. So again, the quantity will come around the multiplication of 2 into 3.4 into 0.9 into 0.9, which is 5.51. We will add both of these, so it will be around 5.15 meters. So the total quantity for earthwork will be 15.56 meters cube. We have included both long work and short work at this level. So our calculation for this is earthwork is at bottom level. Now this is first one. Now go for second one. For quantitating the length of the, again we will go for length, long burst length. So long burst length will be 6.2. We have already taken for long ball, and for short ball it will be 3.4. So again calculating the this is length, now the width and depth. So width of this will be again we are at same level. Width will be 0.9 and depth will be this one 0.3. For both, and the quantity will be multiplication of length, breadth, depth, and its number. So length it will be 2 in numbers and 2 in numbers here also. So 2 into 6.2 into 0.9 into 0.3, which will give around 3.35. And 1.8. So we will add both this and will be around 5.1. So this is the quantity of concrete at the this place. So we are at this level. Now we will go for third one, brickwork. Now Now the third one will be brick work. So brick work in foundation and plinth. So the as I said, when you go this comes from bottom to up, the length of the long wall will decrease and the length of short wall will increase. So now we are at this level. So this is our first footing. So now we'll go one by one for first footing for long wall first. So this first footing in long wall. So there will be two long walls as we know it, and the length of that will be 5.3 plus 0.6. So it will be, the length will be 5.3 plus 0.6. And the breadth will be 0.6. And the breadth and the height or depth will be 0.3. So the quantity will come 2 into 5.6 plus 0.6, 5.9 into 0.6 into 0.3. So that will be, they will come, that value will come as 2.13. Then again for the second footing, the number again will be 2 for long wall. And the now for second footing we are at here. So again 5.3 plus 0.5. So it will be 5.3 plus 0.5. Then after that 0.5, the width. The width will be 0.5. The depth will be 0.3. So again multiplication of this, the quantity will come up to be 1.24. Now for the plinth level, for the plinth level again the norm would be 2 only, and again we are here now this point. So the length will be 5.3 in its center plus for short for long wall plus 0.4. Again the breadth will be 0.4, depth will be 0.6, and the quantity will come out to be 2.74. So as you can see, first of all in first footing it was 5.3 plus 0.6 is 5.9. Again it went down when it decreased to 0.1, so it will be 5.8, and again here is 5.7. So it decreased by almost 0.1 each time. And initially in the earthwork we had 6.2. From there 6.2 it has come down to 5.7. The long wall length come down to 5.7. So the length of long wall is decreasing when they are coming from down to up. Now again the brick working foundation for short wall. Short wall, first of all for first footing. For first footing, again we have to say how many walls are there. 2 walls are there. Now the length, as we all know that for short wall, center to center length of a plan of short wall 4.3. Then we have to minus the half breadth on on this side and it minus half bit on this side. So we have to minus 1 bit in total. So again, at first putting for short wall, we have 4.3 meter as length minus the first putting bread, 1 bread will be 0.6 and then this length now breadth will be 0.6 and depth will be 0.3. So the quantity will be 2 × 3.7 × 0.6 × 0.3, which eventually comes out to be 1.33 meter cube. Again, for the second footing, again two short walls. Second footing is we are at now 50 centimeter. So tools number 4.3 minus 0.5 into 0.5 into 0.3. So again it will come to 1.14 meter cube. Now for the plinth. For the plinth. Again two numbers of short walls. And the length will be, now we are at this one, plinth cube. So 4.3 minus 0.4 into breadth 0.4, depth 0.6. So again, it multiplication of these four quantities will come to 1.87. So he has said that when we come from bottom up, the length of short one will increase. So here the length was, initial length was 4.3 minus 0.9, so it was 3.4. Now here is 4.3 minus 0.6, it is 3.7. Again here it will be 4.3 minus 0.5, it will be 3.8. Here 3.9. So the length of the short wall is increasing while we are coming from bottom to up. So for if we calculate this both quantities of short wall number, the sum of quantity will come as 10.95 meter cube for brick working foundation and plinth in total. Now for the fourth one, this brick work and superstructure first of all we take again long wall and short wall. So long wall will be 2 in number, short wall numbers. Now we are at the level, we consider this level 0.3. so now wall will be the length, it is 0.3. again it will be 0.3. the breadth will be, so for this the breadth will be 0.5 meter. So after adding each of these, the net quantity will come, and that will be fine using a wall and short wall method. Now enter to second method. We have to